Now let's consider fussy cutting. Lucy Boston used her fabric brilliantly, and you can too. There are two methods of fussy cutting with Inklingo and freezer paper. Inklingo No Waste Fussy Cutting is my first choice. It is similar to Stack and Whack. We print identical sheets of fabric to get sets of identical shapes. Traditional Swiss cheese fussy cutting can require a lot more fabric, and it takes longer than printing identical sheets of fabric with Inklingo, but it works beautifully in the right circumstances. Freezer paper templates, with or without Inklingo, are the very best templates for traditional fussy cutting. Templates are ideal for fussy cutting when you don't have a fabric that is suitable for no-waste fussy cutting, or when you don't have enough fabric for no-waste fussy cutting. Templates are also perfect when you only need a few shapes from a particular fabric, or when you need 10 or more identical shapes for designs like the Passacaglia quilt or the other designs in Wylene Hammerstein's Millefiori Quilts books. For Swiss cheese fussy cutting, I use a window template and a template without seam allowances. It makes it easier to cut accurate, identical shapes than it is with an acrylic template or a different window template. You can draw or trace the hexagons from the book to make these two freezer paper shapes. Of course, I print hexagons with seam allowances on freezer paper with Inklingo because I love printing. I cut the freezer paper into sections so I can have as many templates as I need. Next, I want to cut on the stitching line with a rotary cutter or scissors, but before I do, I want to extend the matching marks so I will have them on both shapes. I get a window template and a template without seam allowances from one section. Two for one. I usually mark FP on the paper side so I don't mistakenly touch the plastic side of the template with a hot iron. When you find a design you want, check to see if the design shows clearly on the wrong side of the fabric. This is the case with many fabrics, and it is helpful because we prefer to iron freezer paper templates on the wrong side of the fabric. Working on the wrong side saves an extra step if we will be marking lines on the wrong side of the fabric. On the ironing surface, press the window templates in position over identical designs with a hot dry iron. Repeat until you have found enough identical designs. It's usually okay to ignore straight grain when you're fussy cutting. In this example, I need 4 hexagons. That's another advantage of freezer paper templates. I can have as many as I want. Still on the ironing surface, place the freezer paper shape without seam allowances into the window opening and press it into position. Each identical design is now marked with 2 pieces of freezer paper, the window and the template in the finished size. Still at the ironing surface, peel off the window template, leaving the template without seam allowances in position. Check to make sure they are all identical. You can adjust and repress if necessary. Still at the ironing board, slide a cutting mat underneath and rotary cut around the freezer paper, adding seam allowances. You can use scissors if you prefer, and you choose the width of the seam allowance. Still on the cutting mat, use a mechanical pencil and a thin, flexible ruler to mark the stitching lines, crosshairs, and matching marks to imitate the results you get when you print the shapes on fabric with Inklingo. Ultra-fine, accurate lines. Marking the sewing lines is an extra step, but it is certainly faster than any method of basting for English paper piecing. Here's a tip if you are fussy cutting and the design did not show clearly on the wrong side of the fabric. After cutting the shapes, remove the template and go back to the ironing board to iron it in position on the wrong side of the fabric, centered, so you can mark the sewing lines, matching marks, and crosshairs. It is an extra step, but totally worth it for the right fabric. Imagine how well this works for designs like Passacaglia and all of the other designs in Wileen Hammerstein's Millefiori Quilts books, where you sometimes need 10 identical shapes for fussy cutting. You can have enough freezer paper templates for every identical design, not just one or two pieces of acrylic to slide around. Freezer paper templates are the best for fussy cutting. They can be ironed securely into position for greater accuracy, and I can have as many as I want. They are perfect whether I am marking the sewing lines or not. Once you know how to use freezer paper templates, you will never need to buy acrylic, plastic, or metal templates again, whether you use Inklingo or not. Monkey says, "You're welcome." That's another way we make quilting more accessible. Here is one last tip. If you have Diana Boston's book about Lucy Boston's patchworks, you can draw the templates you need on freezer paper and make all of the quilts, even the ones for which there are no Inklingo shape collections. In addition to the stories about Lucy Boston's life, there are wonderful descriptions of the quilts with enough information that you can draw the shapes on freezer paper, cut them apart, and sew them together. I hope you agree with me that freezer paper templates are the best. Less expensive, easier, faster, and more accurate. And I hope you'll want to share this information with your friends and then go shopping together for fabric for your POTC quilts. I always want to know what you think about my videos. Please check the links below and leave a comment. It also helps me if you click to like the video. If you can draw it or trace it on freezer paper, you can cut it apart and sew it together. Thank you for watching.